Hi, this is a statistics video, and you can get this worksheet on my website at caroleemath.com. And this video is on population, sample, parameter, and statistic, well, the relationship between those four terms. So let's look at this example. Researchers are interested in how many people have been evicted from their housing. Draw a diagram to represent those four terms: population, sample, parameter, and statistic. Okay, so let's draw a big circle. It's more like an oval in my case. And this is the population. And that is the entire group of interest. Everyone that would fit into this category. So how many people have been evicted from their housing? Well, renters are the only ones who can be evicted from their housing. So our population would be renters, whether they're in an apartment, a house, a duplex, any type of rental. If someone owns their house and have a mortgage, they could get foreclosed on, but that would be different than being evicted. So we're looking at renters, and then the question is where. This particular example doesn't specify, but we want to be as specific as possible. Are we interested in renters in Portland, or in Oregon, or in the United States, or another country? Let's just make this the United States for our example here. Okay, so our population would be all renters in the United States. We could even put all. All renters in the United States. Okay, now we want to know how many of them have been evicted. Well, we can't ask everybody. It's nearly impossible. So we want to take a sample. So a smaller circle. The sample is a smaller group that we're going to ask or measure. Could be a survey, and which is why I say ask, or these may, our population may not even be people. It could be car parts or tomato plants, and so we might be measuring some characteristic, or we might be giving a survey. Okay, so we've got population and sample. For our example, let's say we're going to ask 350 renters. We'll talk about sample size and how do we get the sample in another video. Okay, so there's our population, there's our sample. Those are the first two words. Population, sample. Now we go to parameter. Parameter has to do with the population. It's really handy that those two start with P. The parameter is what we are interested in finding out. Now, that's the thing that we want to know. So this is how many people have been evicted. We want to know how many people in the entire US, renters, have been evicted. So this is a theoretical value that we want to know. It's the theoretical, we could say true value for the population. In this case, we probably wouldn't say how many people, but we would say it's the percentage or the proportion of people who have been evicted. So let me use another color for that. I could have said proportion of renters versus proportion of people. Okay. Now, in the same way that we have P and P, population and parameter, sample goes with statistic. The statistic is the value that we calculate from the sample. So while we can't calculate it usually for the entire population, we can count it calculate it from our sample. So the statistic is calculated from the sample. Okay, so in this case, we can all keep going, keep this example going, and we can calculate it. So this would be the, instead of the proportion who have been evicted from our population, this would be the proportion of people in the sample who have been evicted. Okay, so let's say we have a good sample, and out of the 350, 58 said that they have been evicted. And so we can calculate, put my calculator, 58 out of 350. Comes out to 0.165, or if we round that up, 0.17, about 17%. I'll change it to squiggly equals. 0.17, which is 17%, 0.17 is our proportion of the people from our sample have been evicted. So that is our statistic, something we can actually calculate. Now the idea here is we want our statistic to estimate the parameter, right? This is what we want to know for the entire population. So we need to make sure we have a good sample and good methods to take a sample and make sure that that value is representative of the entire population. Okay, so I was just kind of getting into what's a representative sample. So representative sample is one that represents the population, or it has the same characteristics as the population. So representative sample has the same characteristics as the population, at least in the area that we're concerned about. Sometimes people ask, how big of a sample do you need? Some people think, oh, you have to get a really big sample, right? So let's just say you're making some soup as an example. Got lots of good things in your soup there. Okay, so you're making your soup and you want to taste it. Is there enough salt? Do you have all the right things in there that you want? So do you need to eat the whole pot of soup to know if it tastes good? No, you really just need one spoonful, right? So you just need one spoonful, some broth, a pea, a carrot, a piece of chicken or tofu. You just need a very small sample, but it must be representative. If you just blindly dip your spoon in and you don't get any of the vegetables, you're not going to know exactly what it tastes like, right? So a sample does not need to be huge, but it does need to be representative. Okay, so we'll talk more about sampling methods and how we choose these 350 people in the next video. So I'll see you there.